Hi guys, welcome to News Unplugged KE. I'm your host Gabrielle Mosa. Today, as you can see, the location is a bit different. We are at Cooperative University of Kenya for the Youth Conference of the East Africa Digital Summit. Stay tuned for more scenes. We'll be interviewing some people to see what is bringing them here and their experience and what they want to learn, and also some speakers. Stay tuned for more. In the meantime, don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Ray.
You're Ray?
Yeah.
Are you a ray of sunshine?
Obviously, if I make your life bright, why don't I be one?
So tell us, what role are you playing in this event?
I'm the MC. I'm also one of the organizers of this event. Yeah, and that's me. And I see my mate there. Minai!
Okay, why are you so passionate about this event?
I'm passionate about young people. Yeah, that's what I'm passionate about today. That's what I'm so excited about today. I'm excited about these people.
Yeah.
And I'm about to see the transformation that their life is going to take.
Yeah, and what will you be speaking on?
I'll be talking about a lot of things, introducing most of the speakers here. Yeah.
You said you're a speaker.
I'm an MC. Isn't that a speaker too?
It is.
Yeah, so that's me.
Okay, so yeah. Enjoy yourself and see you inside.
Thank you. See you.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Minai Wamwero. Should I look at the screen?
No.
Okay, you're good. Okay. Minai Wamwero. Yeah, I am the business developer at Bitcoin Dada. Yeah, that's about it. And I am a Bitcoin MC. Or you can call me a money MC.
Okay.
Yeah, any money event, any Bitcoin event.
Yeah, you're the MC.
Yeah, I want to be an MC.
What role
will
you be playing? Can you be the MC?
Yes, I'll be the MC, the core MC of the event.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am proud to be co-hosting with Ray. Because we have good energy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, what makes you so passionate about this event, about Bitcoin event?
About first, Bitcoin is the future.
It is
the future. Bitcoin is money.
Yeah.
So the fact that Bitcoin is money, I mean, we use money for everything.
Yeah.
Money, it rules our lives in a way.
Yeah.
So it's the future. That is where money is headed to.
Yeah.
So the fact that money is headed to Bitcoin, I am already there. I'm in it, and I would like everyone to know about it. Yeah, we're the future, and also it is easier. The adoption will be so easy from the young people. When the young people get it, the older people, we are going to take a long time before they understand it. But for the younger people, they are the future. Bitcoin is the future. It's a perfect match. Perfect match. Yeah. You're welcome, and you also look lovely.
Thank you.
Let's go start because we're late.
Hello, Karibu Sana.
Thank you.
Tell us your name.
My name is Ruby Orimba. Mm-hmm. I am the public relations manager at tuco.co.ke.
Okay, and
yes.
You'll be a speaker for this event?
Yes, I will be. I will be discussing the topic of the role of media in digital transformation in East Africa.
Okay.
Yes.
And what makes you so passionate about this? Why are you speaking about this?
Because digital innovation is the future. Actually,
yeah.
It's not even the future, it's already here.
Yeah.
Everything is going digital, not only from from the media point of view, but education, entrepreneurship, and media plays such a big role in helping in this transformation and promoting digital inclusion.
Yeah.
So I'm passionate about this. I'm excited about the East African Digital Innovation Summit. I think it's a great initiative, and I can't wait to hear what the other panelists have to say.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see the kind of great projects that the students are going to be pitching to us. It's going to be a wonderful experience.
All right, thank you very much for that.
Thank you. All right, see you guys inside.
Okay.
All right, bye.
Bye. All right. Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
So my name is Marcel Latieno. I'm the founder of Bitcoin Data, where we focus on financial education for the African female. And we do focus on Bitcoin and its ever-evolving, in this ever-evolving digital space.
Okay. You'll be a speaker at the event.
Yes, I will. Super excited.
What will you be speaking about?
Touching on a topic that touches on everybody, which is money. Money connects us all, you know, globally.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm really passionate about this, and I'm excited to try and inspire the young generation that is here with us today.
Okay. Why should more young people come for such investments?
Of course, the first thing is literacy. That is a very important aspect in this ever-evolving space, right? The moment you have education, then you can actually venture into anything that you want, right? And find your niche, where to plug your skills in. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Owino Masilin.
Okay.
Yeah.
How did you hear about this event?
I heard about the event through my friends, and I saw the posters as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, through social media.
Okay. What are you most excited to learn about today?
Since the event is about to do with digital stuff to do with,
yeah.
I'm expecting to get maybe more innovation, something like that, online
yeah.
works. Yeah. As a person who is pursuing banking and finance as my course,
exactly,
I would love to hear so many things about banking stuff,
online
creation of more job opportunities, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Okay.
My name is Rotich Kibrono. Mm-hmm. I'm from the Cooperative University of Kenya.
Okay.
I'm pursuing a Bachelor of Cooperative Business. Yeah.
So you're a guest today at the event?
Yeah, I'm a guest today at the event.
How did you hear about
that? Okay, I got about to know about the event through the links that are shared by the school president, the school email, and friends.
What are you expecting to learn here?
Okay, I'm expecting to learn about how to get to innovate,
mm-hmm.
how to maybe learn about how I improve my innovation,
yeah.
how to get new ideas,
mm-hmm.
to innovate the ideas that I have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah.
Enjoy the event.
Thank you.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Ian.
Okay.
Yeah.
How did you hear about this event?
Okay, through social media.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are you interested in learning about today?
Yeah, I want to learn about the digital innovation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why should youth come for such events like this?
You know, like in, okay, I don't know how I'll put it, but in today's life, everything is digital.
Yeah.
So it's good to be innovative in terms of digital.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything now is digital.
So someone should get knowledge about this and learn how to shift.
Exactly. Sure. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Enjoy the event.
Okay. Thank you.
Sasa.
Poor Sana.
What's your name?
My name is Joyce Olite. Yeah, student at Cooperative University.
Okay, how do you hear about the event? Is it because you're a student here?
No, I heard the event through posters.
Okay.
And also I engaged in mobilizing the event. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are you excited to learn about today?
I would like to learn more about technology since I do IT.
Mm-hmm.
And also hear different projects from different people and maybe present also my project, yes.
Okay. Yeah. Are you interested in the online space? Doing IT and everything.
Yeah.
Alright, I hope you learn a thing or two.
Yeah.
Okay,
enjoy. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, my name is Jorge from St. Paul's University, and also I'm a student at RCM College. Currently, I'm undertaking my master's in St. Paul's for Business Administration Finance Option,
mm-hmm.
and I'm also a startup and a founder of a company by the name of Financial Zap,
mm-hmm.
and also a co-founder of another startup by the name of Team Seed Africa. So basically, Team Seed Africa focuses on technology and innovation for the youth,
mm-hmm.
and for the financial sub focuses on financial literacy for SMEs and the youth. And so I thought this is a big opportunity for me to come and learn and see how I can interact, network, and learn how can we incorporate the world of finance and the world of digital innovation. So this is a great opportunity for me.
Why should the youth come for such events like this?
I believe this is a great opportunity for the youth, for themselves. Apart from learning, it's a place for them to network, learn from each other. And also, in the next generation, you are now moving from the traditional way of doing things. So the next generation of work, it's innovation and tech. So this is a point whereby if you don't have a skills through the technology, count yourself out of the market in the next 5 years. So this is a great opportunity for them.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you very much and enjoy the event.
Thank you and have a nice day.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hello. I'm Vincent Ucheng, formerly known as Vini. Yeah.
Why formerly known?
I'm so much into campus politics, so that is the name that I use. Most of the comrades refer me to as Vini.
Okay. Yeah. How did you hear about this
event? We heard about the event through the. How do I say? There were some posters that were being spread around, and the fact that I'm from the institution, we particularly engaged in mobilizing most of the people to come out to see the impact of the event. So,
yeah. What are you interested in learning about?
I'm mostly, it's a digital summit, a digital forum summit kind of, so we expect from this event we'll learn, it will provide a creative space that will enable people to realize, where the world is headed to, especially in the innovative world, you get. So that's all we expect from the event, to provide us with, the creative space so that we realize where the world is headed, especially. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much and enjoy your event.
Thank you.
Of this event, Mr. Rain, aka The Sand.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
If it's too cold, don't worry, because the rain is here to warm you. Well, I know you've been thinking about Burning Trees lately and how to plant them. Well, I have a story. It's about how men planted Burning Trees out of blue. And it goes somewhere in a wild soul. So blue, I have found a way to make the money grow, and I'm gonna keep it going on. Keep the money tree growing on. I was told money only lies in the books. I found another way. If you ask me what's the way, well, we may have found it. How you feeling, guys? How you feeling? Are you ready for today? You should act like you're ready for today. So to start us off today, I'm going to introduce the chairman of innovation. He's representing the dean of students for this institution. His name is Dr. Shen Ang, PhD.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. My name is Shen Ang. I'm a faculty at the Cooperative University of Kenya. I teach computing. I'm in the Department of Computer Science, so I teach computing. But the reason I'm standing here is because this is about innovation. And at the Cooperative University of Kenya, we have a very vibrant innovation team whose committee I chair. That's the reason I got a ticket to get into this function. The other reason I got a ticket to get to this function is because I was told I need to come and represent the CEO of the university and the Dean of Students under whose auspices this function is here. And so on behalf of my Vice Chancellor and on behalf of the Dean of Students, I want to welcome all of you to the Cooperative University of Kenya.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. I want to apologize for one thing I did, yeah? I said we're in a relationship and then I did not appreciate you guys for waiting for so long for us to start. So from the team, from all the organizers, we appreciate you so much for giving us your time and for waiting for us to start.
Anyways, I'm thinking, why have such a bad girlfriend who will keep on apologizing to you when you can have Alexa in the future? Think about it. Something that welcomes you whenever you come from wherever you're from. It doesn't ask you why you left home. What's the future of our relationships with Alexa?
Right, you just replaced me with technology.
Yeah, I did.
But I apologized.
No, you're not fair. You're not fair to them. You're in a relationship.
Oh, okay. But I do get it, yeah? Can you imagine coming home during this cold season and the room temperature is perfect because Alexa knows?
Imagine.
Nani anafraia? We are single mbaya. I was single. We are sorry. We should get you Alexa.
I think people in Karen will appreciate Alexa even more. Because it's cold here. It's very cold. I thank God I'm not, even if I was in a relationship and I'm living in Karen, I'll still feel cold.
We're sorry. So, now, I was unable to cut the chairman short because he was the one welcoming us to his grounds. You have to nyenyekea, yeah? So I want to allow someone to... First, let me talk to the speakers. Speakers, hi, welcome. If I say 15 minutes, I mean 15 minutes. I will be here and I will throw you off. I'm sorry. But when I say 15 minutes, please, let's keep it to 15 minutes. I believe that these people want to meet you after these sessions. So give them that time so that they can have one-on-one interactions with you guys.
Don't forget we're in Kenya. We're in Kenya. We are in Africa. Yeah. 15 minutes is...
See, I'm Africa. Not 10 minutes Africa. Thank you, Ray. I mean 10 minutes white man time. Evie, on the dot, like that. Before I continue, we have a representative from the Dean's office. It will be so disrespectful.
From the Dean, Dr. Rosida Moga, who has not been able to come because of other commitment. For the visitors who have come, we wish to welcome you to CUK and especially more so for this East Africa Digital Innovation Summit. Thank you also for the student readers who have organized this and any other readers from the other university. Feel at CUK. Allow me to say something retro about innovation, although I've been given 5 minutes. We have to align ourselves to be innovative by all means, and a good example is the way people have adopted mobile use, which again people have accepted, meaning again all of us, we have adopted technology and everything is becoming digital. There before, like 20 years back, we used actually to have bagging hall, and even today, that thing is finishing up. People have adopted technology where they can transact through mobile and do other things, many things including shopping. You don't have to walk in the shopping mall to do your shopping. You can do it in the comfort of your home. So technology is key, and you as a youth and young men and women of God, this is your time. So adopt it and accept it, actually try to be very innovative in all your ways. Mine is just to wish you the best as you enjoy this summit. Tap as many knowledge which will be shared here as possible. Try to utilize it as well as tap everything which is good, but also be responsible whenever we talk of technology, because we have seen how technology have led young people into trouble. But when you use it responsibly, then all shall be well. For the presenter, Karipuni sana. Wish you well. My minute is over.
Huyo ni mzungu. That's a white man in the soul. Thank you so much for maintaining time and keeping time. DJ, I love what you're doing. Keep doing that. Well, let's start our summit, okay? So, we are going to have our first keynote speaker. Our first keynote speaker is here to tell us about the future of digital transformation. Sasa tumeingia class. Class is in session, okay? All those who came to benefit, the ladies have met in the washrooms, we're already bonding. Hi babes, UN, JQuad. Yes, now we are about to, class is in session. We are about to discuss the future of digital transformation.
Well, all of you have heard about finance, but do you wonder, what is it finance that we're here to talk about here? We have Benjamin Arunda, is a blockchain nerd, he knows a lot about it, and is going to tell you about the evolution of finance. So, let me introduce Benjamin Arunda to you guys. Clap for him. Oh my God, you lack courtesy.
Kwani amjengea relationship na huyu? Hata huyu ako part of the gang. You support, okay?
No, niko taken by the way. I don't care about you.
Thank you so much. Good morning, guys. Good morning. Good morning. Okay, my name is Benjamin Arunda, and I am not going to talk about digital finance or the evolution of it. There are other experts in the room who are going to talk about that. But the topic that I was given was the future of digital transformation. I believe my slides are up. So because I don't have... you're okay? Good. Great. So guys, I have 15 minutes, but I'm going to involve you as I present. Because all of you understand something about digital transformation. And all of you understand something about innovation. So, digital transformation is the integration of technology across an organization to change the way it operates and presents its products or services to customers. Now, that is the definition that I got online. I would like to get a definition from one of you. I have 6 books today to give out, and I'm going to introduce each book as I give it out. Woo. So it's called In Here. So if you help me present, if you help me do this speech well.
Of transactions, and today I'll be talking about the psychology of crypto. So this doesn't necessarily mean it's not limited to cryptocurrency. It's not limited to investing in forex and finance. This is the psychology of investing generally. So you can apply these principles in your investment journey. So my presentation today, my goal will be to hack your mind to become better investors in crypto, in whatever you are investing in, to understand the role that psychology plays in investing. Because I'm always of the opinion that psychology underroots all investing success. So I always say that good psychology is good investing. So first of all, why is psychology so important in an investor's journey? Why does psychology play a role in investment? So you might have the best financial knowledge. You have a PhD in Harvard in finance. You have all the experience, the connections, and everything you need to know and knowledge in finance generally, and you could still lose it all in the market. You could still lose everything. Like in 1998, a very large hedge fund, it was at the time the third biggest hedge fund in the US at the time, they got wiped out during a bullish market. You know, it's one thing to lose money on a normal market day or during the bear market. Please, you understand what a bull market and a bear market is, right? I didn't hear yes. Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, so it's one thing to lose money during a bullish market and to actually lose money during a bearish market and to actually lose money during a bullish market. So the one of the third biggest hedge fund in the US that had Nobel laureates. Nobel laureates are people that won prizes in finance. They had the smartest mind working for them, and they got wiped out in a bullish market. Now you can look at this and be like, what actually happened? If you can't control your sense of fear, your sense of greed, they obviously became overconfident, and that's why they got wiped out. Now, on the other hand, you might have zero experience in investing. You don't have any experience with investing, and you can still make profits on your investments if you can understand patience, endurance, staying through the bouts, being able to be patient and wait when you are losing 80% of your portfolio. So this is like a very, very sensitive point. So it's always very difficult when someone says that when you're losing 80% of your money and someone is saying you should keep holding and you shouldn't worry about it. But it's a difficult decision to make, right? So I'm trying in psychology and how psychology underroots or investing success, you should understand that anything you do in investment, you actually need some form of psychology. So these terms, endurance, patience, greed, fear, are not financial terms, but like they are psychology terms. I can't come and tell you that someone that does not have any experience as a surgeon or a medical doctor can probably come out one day and he should operate on someone. It doesn't work for that. But for finance, psychology plays a major role.
The major problem which we all have in the financial market is funding, capital, right? Like somebody was asking, how many people have been trading here before? How many of you guys have been trading? How many of you guys have lost your money, your added money into the market? You know, the good thing is, yes, it's very easy to lose money into the market, right? And at the same time is you can make crazy amount of money in this forex market. Do you understand? Now, why we are here today is, in our 7 years experience in the financial market, we are able to create a solution for you guys out there. Why blow your other money in this forex market, right? Why blow the money you suffer to make and just lose it anyhow in the forex market? That's why we created a platform called Consummate Traders Proprietary Fund. Now this is to help every trader coming on board. We'll give you capital instead of using your own money, right? We'll provide you the capital. Now you see this is starting to make sense that you can start trading today and you don't need to use your money. Is it making sense? Right? You can start trading today and you don't need to use your money. And you can make money off it. Now, the good part is this. Like I said, you don't need to lose your own money in this forex industry. Now, you can lose our own money. We take care of the risk, right? And if you make profit, you get the what? You get the 90% percentage of the profit. Does that sound good? Let me ask. People over there?
Yes.
I'm not getting the energy I want.
Excellent.
Excuse me, what do you say? Okay, let's start about this. Should we do like some money giveaway to the you guys to know that there's money? Okay, let's start by this. $100 for one person that will repeat what Consummate Trader is all about.
Like, well, I'm just the impression I say, you know. Who's that impression? I don't lie. No, you are.
He's asking. He said $100 for anyone who's able to explain what $100 is all about. He's asking, he's saying, anyone can explain what consumer trader is all about, what he has explained, that that person is going to be gifted $100. You can learn how to speculate, know when to hop in the forex market, know when to get out and also make your own tangible song. So I've been able to own several cars. Right now, I think I own about 7 cars, supercars in Nigeria. I own one in Qatar, and also my friend, he has several. Maybe you'll be able to tell you guys his story. So that's why it's important you guys come on board, learn what forex trading is. Now, let me just do one thing for us. You can just pull up your phone, maybe an Android or iPhone, just go on the website and check Consummate Trader. So you guys know what we're talking about. However, apart from this one, I'm going to be giving away right here for those who are going to be answering our questions. We're also going to be giving away $5,000 account to 10 lucky winners today. All right, you go on.
Maybe you know your name, okay?
Let me just repeat.
He said we're giving out $5,000 account to 10 people. $5,000 times 10, how much is that? That's $50,000 we're giving out here. And which means that if one of you can make good money out of the $5,000 we're giving you, you are taking 90% of the profit home. Does that make sense? Yeah. Right? So, I think this is going to benefit people that have probably been trading before, you know. But how does this work? Whoever does, if you don't know how to trade, you can what? You can start right now. Maybe this is going to motivate you guys right now. Maybe you just want to bring out your phone, everyone, right? I just want you to check us out on Instagram. So you can see that whatever we are telling you is what? Is real.
Now seeing is believing.
Does that make sense? Seeing is believing, right? Now I'm sure that when he said he asked him, look at his life.
This guy is broken.
Right? So, you can do this on Instagram. You can just search out there where you can be displayed here. You can be displayed. Okay. Nice. You just put out Jeffrey Benson and Abby Burke on the spot. Before they can display it, you can just set out Jeffrey Benson.
Jeffrey
_ Benson. Jeffrey _ Benson on Instagram. Have you guys seen that? Are you believing now? Are you starting to believe? Don't worry, there's more money to be won here. Right? So now you can go to also search Abby Forrest. H-A-B-B-Y, then Forex. Do you get that? Set H-A-B-B-Y, F-O-R-E-S, _ Academy. You found it, who found it? Don't worry, you won yourself 5,000 already. What's your name? Daniel. Nice. You found, what are you, a consummate chef? Nice. Thank you. Who has found it here?
You found it?
Yeah. Nice. Are you believing? This is a Lamborghini?
Yeah.
How much does a Lamborghini cost in Kenya City?
Right?
400,000 Kenya City. How much does it cost in Kenya City? Lamborghini Euro.
Very few
around.
Right.
12 million Kenya shillings. 740.
Wait, like one person, like what is 12 million $2? Nah, that's way too low. In euros cost about $350,000 to $400,000.
So how much is $400,000 to Kenya shilling? 48 million. 49 million. Whatever it is. That is what you can achieve it. You know, you just figure what you can have that in your bank account. I go to any car store and be like, today, this guy is mine. You know what? I used to tell everyone who is trading, I tell them this, you deserve to ride in the Lambo, right? You deserve to own the Lambo because actually it takes a lot to become a forex trader. You know why? Now, as a forex trader, you're putting in a lot of work. You might just think that, okay, you're sitting down on your laptop, you're making money, but at that moment, every part of your body, your psychology, your emotion, everything is what? It's put into the work. You understand? So it takes a lot to become a what? A forex trader. I can even say, to become a professional forex trader is way hard work than anybody doing 9 to 5. But it's very easy to make the money, right? Just sit down on your laptop, in your comfort zone, and make the money. So who wants to become a forex trader today?
Energy's changing now.
I'm still seeing that energy. Who wants to become a forex trader today? Amazing. Now, for those new people who want to become a forex trader, don't worry about funding, don't worry about capital, right?
Utilizing the free resources and materials that are available for you on the website, on Google, just go, what is forex trading, how to start forex trading in Kenya. You can start there. Even other guys who are also killing it right here in Kenya that are trading and making crazy profits, all right? So if you check my story, since you said you found my page, Jeffrey Lasco Benson on Instagram, if you check my story, how much did I make yesterday? I think you were telling me yesterday, you're showing me, right, when I came in, how much I made yesterday. Just check, how much did I make yesterday? You can just check. Sorry?
Who said 78k?
Who said 78k?
The guy? Yeah. You owe yourself a consumer check.
So who said $100,000? Someone said $100,000. I'll have to share that. Someone said $100,000, right?
Okay.
So come on. Just want to sell me $100.
Yeah.
Pick up. like these things, these are money. Oh, what person, like now, I'm shocked. Everyone said, like, what? Then you know how to do rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. So, oh, let's do it, season 9. Rock, paper, scissors.
You want yourself a thing?
Rock, paper, scissors.
Like, this is too much.
Put your name here, then we'll do a raffle. And the guys who are at the front, put your name here. Remember, the rest of us are hungry. So kindly be a bit civilized because this is not giving the vibe at all.
Digital Innovation Summit was amazing was who? Please, lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. All right, so let's do something else. Let's talk about Nigeria Sibio. So we're gonna do, we're gonna start with clapping 10 claps. Put it to people. So, and this is to call up the event. I do after here, we're supposed to go and date. And then, as we're doing that, I'd like to invite the East Africa Digital Innovation Summit organizers, Obina, Essie, Dr. Mathieu, Ray, Minai, Malimuko, please start coming to the podium. So anyways, let's start with Ukionam Tonakosea. We're supposed to start, we count 10, then we count 8, then we count 6, then we count 4, then we count? Huh? 3? 2. We're not going to show you the pattern recognition, eh? So Ukionam Tonakosea pattern recognition, Uniambie. Alright, so anyways, let's get started. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's do a test. 10 claps. So let's go to the next one. 8 claps. Let's go. 6. Which university is this? What are you? Hey! By the way, you guys have to talk about AI. So, you have to force up to be AI. So, I do a comparative. ChatGPT, go ahead. Alright, so, let's go to 4. So, let's go to 2. Alright, let's go to 0. Alright, so, this team, please, SC Ray, President Ray. So, to when you pay $1, Munione, so, you may attend, eh? Yeah. Alright, SC, please come on board. Kobina, are you on? Minai? Dr. Mathieu. Alright, since we're the only ones, I have a part. Guys, we had a whole team of people who made this happen, and I'm sure that we're gonna have more. So before we take a break, I'd like you guys to do the same way that we've done, clapping. Let's start with 10. Clap for the entire team. 10, 10, 2, 3.